Welcome.
To You Should Read This. I am Christina. I am the Thayer Public Library's teen librarian. And this month for October, I'm going to focus on some spooky books. I'm going to give you 3 recommendations in less than 5 minutes. All right, start the timers. First up is our oldie. For this, I chose And the Trees Crept In by Don Kurtigich. What it's about? When Scylla and Nori are forced to leave their childhood home, they flee to their aunt's home, an oddly colored house some ways outside of the forest. Scylla talks about endless creaking, eerie stillness at night, and begins to find secrets within the house. Why does it seem that ever since they arrived, the trees have been creeping closer? Who is the beautiful boy who's appeared from the woods? And who is the tall man with no eyes who Nori plays with in the basement at night? No one else can see. Why you should read it? This book has just enough spook to get you in the mood for fall and Halloween. It takes a turn that you won't expect, and it has this really cool use of mixed media, including journal entries, found letters, and pages turning black. Next up is our newbie pick. For this, I went with Serpent and Dove by Stephanie McEwen. What it's about? 2 years ago, Louise LeBlanc fled her coven and took shelter in the city of Caesarine, forsaking all magic and living off whatever she could steal. There, witches like Lou are hunted, they are feared, and they are burned. Sworn to the church as a chasseur, Reed Diggory has lived his life by one principle: thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. His path was never meant to cross with Lou's, but a wicked stunt forces them into an impossible union, holy matrimony. The war between witches and the church is an ancient one, and Lou's most dangerous enemies bring a fate worse than fire. Unable to ignore her growing feelings, yet powerless to change what she is, a choice must be made, and love makes fools of us all. Why you should read it? The huge cliffhanger has been killing me. Because Blood and Honey, the sequel to the duology, just came out, you can easily catch up. It has a rich Paris-inspired environment and turns some tropes on its head. There is a romance here and some kissy stuff, so it's a high school-aged recommendation as well. And our last pick this month is our audiobook pick, and for this I went with Sadie by Courtney Summers. Trigger warning for abuse. What it's about? We follow Sadie, a missing girl on a journey of revenge. Sadie hasn't had an easy life, raising her sister Maddie and trying to provide a normal life for the both of them. But when Maddie is found dead and a somewhat botched police investigation follows, Sadie is determined to bring her sister's killer to justice and begins to follow the small clues to finding her killer. We follow West McCrae, a man who overhears Sadie's story and becomes obsessed with finding the missing girl. He starts his own podcast as he tracks Sadie's journey, trying to figure out what happened and hoping to find her before it's too late. Why you should read it? The way this audiobook is produced is so interesting. Half of the audio is told in this journalistic podcast style, while the other half is told from Sadie's perspective at an undisclosed time, and it keeps you speeding through the story. So those are my 3 recommendations for this month. I will see you next month in November for some more reading recommendations. Bye!